Hi, good morning. Hope everyone is doing well today. I'm gonna be doing marine portraits. To get an idea of what we're gonna be doing, there's a couple from previous days. That one's from Tuesday. And this one's from yesterday. So I think I might do this the rest of this week, maybe part of next week, depending. Just don't wanna do too many because I know like I'll burn myself up, but honestly they're really fun. Okay, so let's get started. I think with this one I kind of want to use more lighter tones. Like this one I used I didn't use an explicit outline. That looks really pretty. I personally really like lip makeup where like the inner part is darker. Like you see that in a lot of like Korean makeup. It's supposed to look more natural. Okay, so this is the ref I'll be using today. Definitely a lot of darker tones. See a little bit of shadow here. The lip and nose shape are definitely really interesting on this one. Because like, see how the head is tilted upwards so you can see up the nostril? And the lip shape, it's not like a full front facing, so it's definitely gonna be, like you're gonna have to use a lot more mid-tones to get that defined shape. Right now I have my rep like propped up in front of me, that way I'm looking at it face on, because when you're drawing in at angle, that's how you get your proportions off. Right now I usually always work on a binder, that way it's at more of like a front facing angle when I'm drawing versus looking at a flat desk, because you're looking at it at like a 30 degree instead, so your rendering won't be as accurate. Yeah, right now I'm just placing basic shapes. This is an upward angle. It's gonna be a little bit more difficult to identify the different forms are. Or for me at least. I'm so used to doing just front-facing portraits. honestly think the shapes are coming along really nicely. Usually I'm trash at upper angles, but like this form looks pretty solid. Lip shape looks nice. Nose needs a bit more touching up still. I can never remember which way to turn the lens to zoom in. Like, I can literally never remember. Like, I know my left from my right, but I can never remember, like, which way to turn the dial. That was weird, my streaming software like blacked out for a second. Okay, anyway, I think I'm gonna go ahead and start inking. I think this one I definitely have to use a lot less implied implants or explicit lines on the nose. I think what I'll do, like, I still want to work with outlines because I really like how outlines look personally. I think what I'll do is just use like a medium tone gray to outline the nose, similar to the lips, like yesterday, probably. Okay, so I did all the blocks that I want to do for now. I think for this one, I want to add a couple medium gray highlights in the hair. So I'm going to wait to do any outlines with the black until I have the face fully developed. Right now I'm just rinsing off my brush. I made the mistake yesterday of putting my eyedropper on my laptop, so I'm an idiot. And some of the water dripped into the speakers. I mean, it's fine, it's not broken or anything, but I was just like, oh my god, why'd I do that? Let's see. I'm trying to think which gray I want to use. I usually use, with all my indie inks, I pre-mixed bottles. See, this is a 1 to 50 ratio. So this is 1 drop ink to 50 drops water. And then I also swatched the gray. To compare, this one is a 1 to 8. And then this one is a 1 to 50. So you can see the tone difference. That way I don't have to mix every time. I think I'll go with the 1 to 50. And then 120. And then darkest gray 1 to 8. It's really convenient too to have a premix. Like, I remember I was doing inks last year, no, 2 years ago, and I thought of the idea. I was like, oh my god, that's so smart. Because I've never seen anyone do that. Because, like, most people, like, with watercolors, you mix as you need it. But I was like, if you're gonna make the same grays, like, might as well just premix. Definitely using the medium grain, the nose looks nice. I think I will go down maybe that part with the full black. And maybe touch up some of the nostrils to make them a little bit darker. Can't even see, sorry, I'm adding details. The necklace. Oh, wrong way. Going in with the light green now. morning, Booper. Hope you're doing well today. Working on inks. I'm just about done with this one, actually. Just a heads up, I don't really talk much. Like, I keep it pretty chill. I mean, like, because my mic is kind of sus, so it doesn't work all the time. But, yeah. Hope you're doing well. Ah, glad to hear. Still working on your portfolio, or just chilling today? Yeah, this part that I'm inking right now is actually my favorite part. Like, I really like doing finer details with the hair. Definitely, like, the most pleasing part to do. Epic. How much work do you actually have to do for your portfolio? It's like, I'm doing school right now, and they basically accept anyone. So, I didn't have to make a portfolio or anything. So how many pieces do you have to make? This seems like a lot. 20? Oh my gosh, that's insane, man. Did they give you a timeline, or like, what's the due date? Oh, that's crazy, 20 pieces. November? Okay. That's not too bad. The solid. Sorry, I'm counting. 3 months? Okay. You can do it, man. For sure. I think it's cool because, like, my personal, like, wispy style, like, I usually do rounded strokes. So, to me, it looks a lot more like branches. Like, in the rough that I'm looking at, a lot of the strands are more, like, edgy in terms of curvature, but mine are, like, more long and flowy. Because I need to try and work on my own personal style. Because I'm so stuck in just, like, using references and trying to do realism. Something that I'm trying to get better at. Yeah, I agree in the style thing. Yeah, because, like, I'm so stuck in, like, I need to try and adapt it. And also, I just need to draw just more. Because there was a year where I didn't draw. In school, I mean college. I'm not a child. But, yeah, so I've been drawing a long time. A thing that, like, I'm not liking too much with this is, like, the hairline. I'm gonna make it a bit more jagged. Make it a little bit more natural. Not too rounded. I'm a child, yes. I like to keep my streams PG-13. Like, I'm very much the type. Sorry, I had to cough. Where, like, I'll talk about anything. Like, I don't care. I'm pretty open. It's just, like, I'm not gonna, like, leak anything, you know? So I'll keep it PG-13 for you. Minimum effort, you know? But it's interesting because, like, just like any kid can go on the internet now. Like, it's low key kind of scary. Because I didn't go on YouTube till I was like 10. But there's like little babies using YouTube now, which is kind of concerning. It's seven. Okay. Okay. You're almost an adult. That is good. It's funny because, like, there's a lot of. Is like I'll browse like smaller streams and chat because I think it's fun, and it's also really encouraging to the people who are broadcasting to have someone engaging when you have like no viewers. And just want to say, there's a lot of like younger people streaming art. Like, it's really cute. It's really endearing. They're like, oh, they actually want to like pursue it. But then I'm like, I can't be saying certain things if there's like a child broadcasting. It's funny. I was perusing the art tag the other day, and one of the bios just said, I'm a minor, and I'm like, uh-oh. It's funny. Yeah, this hair is looking kind of shaggy. Like, a lot of the strands are falling down. It makes sense, though, because her head is tilted. Probably got catcalled. Yeah, that's why. Like, I would never do like online dating. Like, it's low key kind of sus. Like, I'm new to like Twitch stuff. Like, I only started watching like November last year, so almost a year. But like, I would like joining like Discord and stuff is scary to me because like I don't know who you are. But yeah, I only really go on like IG, Facebook. Tumblr. I don't interact with people. I usually just like look at art and stuff. This is looking pretty solid, not to brag. Like, this one is definitely a lot more detailed than the ones I did couple days ago. There is a lot more detailed. I'm like, do you dress skirts? Nice. I thought about it. I think it'd be fun to join like an art Discord. Mainly because like I think it's really important to encourage people to be creative. Because that's honestly like where careers are gonna be, because you know automation is gonna take over. I think it's really good to encourage people to draw and create. Especially when there's a limit to how much you can do in school. Yeah, right now I'm just touching up some lines. Think it's interesting that this neckline is really thick, and like the shadow below it is fairly large as well. It's definitely really fun to work with inks. Like, I think experimenting with line width is really fun. Because you can add a lot of weight and depth with increasing or decreasing the line width. Just realized I never erased the pencil lines. Rip. That's the nice thing about India ink, is that it dries fairly quickly. So you don't necessarily have to worry about like tearing your paper when you're erasing. Oh, you're fine, Booper, you're fine. I'll watch double streams too. It's low-key fun to hop between different streams. Like right now, I listen to a lot of Hassan, so usually I'll have it on in the background. So you're fine, I get it. I appreciate that you're here though. Because what I hope ultimately is to have an environment where people feel comfortable to share what they make, you know? Because you don't want to discourage anyone. You probably seem chill, yeah. I'm trying to get gaming set up, and dummy me, like, I watched all the tutorials, all the videos, and like, what to do to stream, what equipment you need, and like, the one thing I didn't do was do a test stream. And I started streaming August 2nd, so about 3 weeks ago, almost a month, and I, my internet was crap, like my upload speed was 5, right now it's 30, so, you know, we popping off. And I went for 2 hours, and I had like 6 unique viewers, so I was like, holy shit, that's a lot of people, right? But like, no one stayed, and I watched the VOD, because like, no one was really in chat, and a guy near the end, he's like, you know, your mic's doesn't sounds really scratchy. I was like, oh no. And like, I ended stream and I watched the VOD, and like, it was so laggy, the audio was shit, because I'm streaming from a MacBook, and it's a MacBook from 2017, so the processing capacity isn't as good as like a MacBook from 2019. So, oh, it's bad. But my MacBook can't handle game capture and audio. So, like, I could do gaming stream, but no audio. So, don't really want to do that. But I ordered a new laptop, so hopefully that'll be coming in soon. That way I can do... All you gaming frogs can watch me play game. I mean, I use a Dell laptop. Yeah, I think I got... I have to look at it again, because I don't know anything about, like, tech. I'm just like, I Googled what is the best laptop for streaming, and then like, there's a top 10 list, and the first one was like $5,000. I was like, nah, I can't do that. That's like all my savings, dude. I think it was Alienware. It was like 2000. And like, I needed a better laptop anyway, because like, when I use like any Adobe programs, it gets hella laggy, because it has a much larger processor the one I bought, so it should be able to handle gaming. Because what I want to do, if I do gaming content, I want to integrate art into it. Because a month ago, if you check on my IG, don't want to leak anything yet, like, I made these Mario Kart theme buttons. So that's going to be integrated into like real content soon. Because I think the concept of like getting badges or like some type of item, that way you're not just playing a game, there's like some art element behind it, is a really good concept. So hopefully that'll launch either next week or the following week once I get my capacities figured out. One thing I don't like about this indie ink, it's labeled super black, but it has like a brown undertone. Like, it's not a cool gray. It's a warm gray. So it has a bit more of a brown or an orange hue. Like, if you want to get a super solid black, you have to do like one or two layers of black. But it is fun to work with. It's not as precise as if you were working with like a fine liner pen, but just the feel of the brush. It's nice. So this jacket or shirt is going to need two coats of black. That way you minimize or you get full coverage, and then you can cover up any overlapping strokes. Because India ink doesn't really blend like watercolor. It dries basically instantly. So you have to be very careful with what strokes you make. Like under the neck here, you can see a little bit of overlap there. So that's not a clean gradient, which is fine. I kind of like the unclean look sometimes. Because it's fine there because it's a gradient. But if it's a solid fill like here, I like when there's full coverage. Honestly, any ink kind of stinks. Like it smells rotten almost. I was debating whether or not to keep the top white, but I think because to give it a bit more balance, it's best to have dark, light, and then dark elements. It would make the hair stand out a lot more, but I feel like it'd be more balanced if the top was black. right now, just adding second layer of black to get that full coverage. I usually tend to get a bit careless when I'm doing second coats, so I'm trying to concentrate really hard right now. Honestly, really loving how this is coming out. So I was kind of sus, not kind of worried. So I usually don't do like upward angle shots or refs. Like this is the ref. Doesn't look exactly like it, but still looks pretty good on its own. Okay, second coat is down. I'm gonna touch up some of the lines to make them a bit cleaner. botched it. Botched that line. It's okay though, easy fix, easy fix. Right now, just doing touch-ups. So just about done. Have to touch that up with a lighter gray again. Okay, I think touch-ups in black are done. Yeah, not a problem, Boober. Thank you for popping in today. Really appreciate it. Good luck getting those 20 pieces done. I'll see you around, man. Okay, so I'm gonna grab my lightest gray and touch up the bottom lip a little bit. That's touched up. Right now I'm just looking for anything else that may need. I'm gonna try and darken this a little bit. Give it a cover up. Overlap. Okay, so I think I just gotta add couple white highlights, and then this one is done. I'm gonna rinse my brushes real quick. So I have a bad habit of letting my inks or paints sit overnight in the palette, and it's a pain to clean them. Okay, highlight is added to the eye. Okay, I'm just looking for if there's any other spots I need to erase. Because I'm probably gonna scan later today. Okay, so I think it is done. Go ahead. Some close-ups. This is it at a full facing angle, because this before is at a, like a 45. Some close-ups. Definitely the angle looks kind of weird. I think this eye shape is more true to the reference, but I like this shape this one has. Lip is definitely darker, but I still like the look of having like the darker towards the inside. I like how like the hairs in the face are really strandy. I like that look a lot. And then I added not an explicit black outline, but just like a varied to give it a bit more texture. I think this gradient right here looks really nice. Okay, so that is the final for today. Definitely a pose out of my comfort zone. like I said, it doesn't look exactly like the ref, but I think it looks pretty good on its own. Okay, so I'm gonna end it here today. Really fun. Really liking these inks. Yeah, so I'll be back tomorrow, same time, 10 a.m. PST. Probably do more inks. I might do it into next week. We'll see. Because it all depends on if I get gaming set up. So I'll figure out a more schedule from there. Because what I kind of want to do is do like an hour or two of gaming. And then one or two of art a day. That way I either go... Ooh, she was bugging out for a second, sorry. Yeah, because I definitely want to try and reach more people. That's the goal. But we'll see. Okay. Thank you to anyone who tuned in today. Like I said, I'll be back tomorrow doing more art. Yeah. Okay. Hope you all have a good one. Bye.